Good afternoon, children. This is the thermal decomposition activity that we have to study. And I'll be telling you what all things have to be taken a note of while doing an activity. Whenever we study an activity, we need to know what is the aim of that activity. Reading simple text and learning is a different thing. And studying an activity is altogether different. Whenever we study about any activity, we should be clear about the aim. The aim of studying this activity is, how does decomposition reaction take place? And what all are the things that we have to observe? And what are the conclusions that we have to make while doing this activity? An activity on thermal decomposition of ferrous sulfate crystals. Ferrous sulfate crystals, they are green in color, and as you take it in the test tube and start heating them, what precautions are to be taken, you can see from the diagram. As you can see that the mouth of the test tube is kept away from the observer. There are fumes coming out of the test tube, and the girl is trying to smell the fumes by covering her nose with her palm. These are the points where in the examination you are asked questions. You are given four different diagrams with different positions of hands, and you will be asked to identify that which one is the correct diagram. So you need to correctly observe what exactly is the position of the test tube and what are the precautions taken by the girl while observing the property of smell. Then coming to the procedure, as you can see that in the test tube we have taken ferrous sulfate crystals, 3 grams ferrous sulfate crystals, and in a dry boiling tube. Why it should be dry? Because ferrous sulfate crystals, they contain 7 molecules of water in them. As you can see here in the text part, FeSO4.7H2O. These 7 H2O molecules, they are present in the salt which are not visible to us. But these 7 water molecules, they make the crystals green in color. Remember this. Now coming to the procedure again, note the color of the ferrous sulfate crystals. All of you will answer here that the crystals are green. You have to write these answers in the book which you have. Heat the boiling tube over the flame of the burner of spirit lamp as shown. Please observe the heating carefully, how we are heating it, and then observe the color of the crystals after heating. You will have to write down the observations here, and the observations would be that first the green color would disappear. I would like all the students to make a note on this. After reading the procedure, you are going to write down the observations. Observation is something that you see during an experiment. So first observation would be that the green color of the crystals will disappear. And the second observation would be that the green color of the crystals changes into reddish brown color of ferrous oxide. As you can see in this equation, that on heating ferrous sulfate, after heating, the product that you get is ferric oxide, and this ferric oxide is reddish brown in color. So final result of this activity is that the green colored ferrous sulfate crystals, these crystals, first they become colorless due to loss of water of crystallization, and then the colorless crystals of ferrous sulfate, they change into reddish brown ferric oxide crystals. And these two gases, SO2 and SO3, these are gases which have a smell of burning sulfur. So now your observations will include change in color. Green color of the ferrous sulfate crystals has changed into first colorless, then reddish brown. Second observation would be a smell of burning sulfur. And third observation would be that thermal decomposition of the ferrous sulfate crystals have taken place, and the conclusion that you will make after studying this activity is that on heating ferrous sulfate crystals, thermal decomposition takes place. and you will support your answer with a equation proper.